you know? And for a guy on the, you know, on a platform that you've never met, doesn't know the full extent of your life, I mean, at some point, it's, we have to take stuff that we hear and grow from it. And then there's stuff that doesn't, like they say, if it don't apply, let it fly. And if that was a week ago or some days ago, and that's still bothering you like that, then you're really giving, you know, some person's opinion or dialogue too much weight.
What is bothering me is it was just for him to claim that he was sitting in the back listening to why I talked. And then to go on to say, oh, well, I was in a relationship and the person only became abusive because I didn't want them. He has no idea what he's talking about. I didn't go but so deep about the story. And I'll be real, real honest with you. I didn't even tell the whole story and I never would, especially with the feedback that right. I get. I'm not asking nobody to feel sorry for me. I just ask for respect, and that is it. And I don't feel that we got that.
But you're not
I think, and this is why I named this podcast this, why doesn't women like to assume responsibility? And I think it becomes more apparent as we go on that why a lot of relationships are not working. Because to me right now, the women are not willing to assume accountability. That so they assume it with some blame on someone else. But I could only be accountable. I'm responsible for my actions. Right. If I go out and I break into a, I'm responsible for that. It doesn't matter if I Jaidir told me to do it. You think they're gonna just go and arrest Jaidir? They're gonna get me too, because I was responsible in that. Right, my part. Jaidir could be sticking up someone. If I'm in the vicinity, they're going to say that you had a responsibility to try and prevent him to do that. So now they're going to get me on conspiracy.
Yep.
Just for being associated with that particular situation. Mm-mm. Because I have a responsibility for my own actions and behavior. And since I didn't prevent it, I'm guilty also.
Like
so,
I said,
and so that's what I mean about, you know, women are say this and that, but it usually all, and I think this call has proven it. Go back and listen to it. Always has to be based on something that someone, because what you're really saying is that, you know, if he would control his mouth, then you wouldn't have responded the way that you were. It would be beautiful if the world was like that, but unfortunately, that's not the real world. There's always going to be someone to say something in opposition to what we like, but we have a choice of how we're going to respond to it, as I try to explain that night.
And what I've just learned tonight, I've learned, my takeaway from this is, one, I have to still work on my inner feelings about what it is. I have to be careful where I share my story, because I still feel disrespected, and that's the part that bothered me. Like I said, my response to it, I take responsibility for it, but it lets me know that I'm still tender in that area, and I'm not ready to be sharing my stories on anybody's platform to give anybody any room to have accusatory and start pointing fingers after the fact. And that's just where it's at, and I'm good on that.
So can I ask a question? How do you see yourself getting over your trauma then? How are you going to do that?
I just have to, find a way to release it, because I didn't really even realize how bothered that I am. And I don't ever show the side of myself. And I don't want nobody's pity. Only thing I ask for is respect, and that's it. So I didn't realize how tender this was in myself. Because I've never actually put it out there in this way. I haven't done that in a long time. And for me to be as poor and as tender as I am about the situation, there's still some healing that needs to be done. And I'm thankful for that being brought to the surface. But there is a safe place to share your story, and some places are not. And I just don't feel like this is the place for it. So I withdraw my whole thing. I send my apologies or whatever. But yeah, I'm still very much broken over it. And again, I don't need nobody's sympathy. It's not about sympathy. It's just about respect. And that's it.
I could argue.
So to you, Mr. Taza, I apologize.
I could argue that he's been hurt. And that's why, see, people express hurt differently. Well, that's why he comes across so aggressively. Alicia acknowledged that, but your hurt is more important than his, right? Because you're a female. Is that what I'm hearing?
Not the, it's the nature of the hurt. I can live with being hurt by some outside partner. We were talking about my childhood sexual.
You don't know. See, you're not qualified to speak for what he's been through because you don't know him.
But when I'm not saying whatever it is he talks about relationship, based on what he said. But I'm talking about, I'm being transparent about my hurt. Not that my hurt.
He ever talked to you about a relationship? My point is this.
No,
he could have actually been hurt also. But your hurt is more important than his because you're a female. Is that what I'm hearing?
I never said that. And I was not the one that attacked Clean when he was on there. Woman is the reason why.
Don't think it's an attack telling a heterosexual man to stop dealing with women and deal with men. You don't think that's an attack?
Excuse me. I didn't start that attack.
You think that's an attack or not?
No, I don't think it was an attack.
Okay, all right.
Retaliation then.
Insult. I gave back an insult.
That's an attack on his person, man, and his manhood. And this is what I'm talking about.
It becomes
apparent while relationships. This is a prime example of why a lot of relationships don't work because women don't want to assume responsibility and accountability. It's becoming more apparent the more we talk.
He started that.
It doesn't really matter.
It doesn't matter.
You hit me first.
This sounds so childish. This sounds very childish.
It mattered to me. But what does this
say?
It's not a safe place for certain conversations because everybody is responsible. And I take it responsible for what I do. However, I want to start that.
Put
on
that.
Sister.
See,
this
is a thing, man. And this is people, I want you people to consider this. No two people express hurt the same way. Some people that's been hurt, they express their hurt in aggression, and people don't like that. So they'll lock them up. But a woman could express her hurt through tears and pain, and everybody feels sorry. But you don't know if the guy over there, he could be hurting just like her, but no one cares because he's a guy. So just suck it the hell up.
That's what I'm, because he could get on this platform at any time and be transparent and brave enough to share this story. No, the mistake I made was being. Now, but I'm good. It will never happen again. His pain. But I don't know attention to attacking people. I don't.
Sharon, can you switch to the computer because you're going in and out, sir?
I can't. I tried that. For whatever reason, my device isn't.
No, I think it's you that's going in and out, Kadar. She's in here.
No.
She's clear. I think it's you, Kadar.
No, it's like when she was talking.
You're doing a staticky right now. Huh? No. It's not hers. It's yours.
Come. Sharon, let me paint a picture for you. The moment that you are faced with that situation again, because you will be, eventually you're gonna have to talk about it again if you really want to get through it, right? When you talk about it again, and the moment that somebody gives you negative energy in that regard, you know, triggers that trauma again, right? You'll only know that you have strength to endure when you no longer feel or receive that attack the same way that you did with Clean, right? So the only way for that to happen is for you to have a different response from that type of attack or response from another person, right? There's no other way to grow from trauma, right, that deep, unless being faced with it head to head, right? So you did the right thing. You was courageous enough by speaking about it, right? Especially on a public platform, right? People will commend you for that. But when now you're justifying that, using that to justify your actions as to why you disrespect another man, right? Then that just goes to show, you know, you didn't really have the strength to speak about it. Also, you also don't have the strength to get over it, right? But again, there's no way for you to endure that trauma until you're able to change your response to it, right? It's a willpower thing. It's not more so I'm going to think about it. You know, I'm going to keep it to myself, you know, harbor it, you know, not speak about it again. You have to be able to be uncomfortable and make a decision in those moments, right? But that's why we're trying to help you take accountability as to what you can do differently. See, you didn't do anything wrong by coming to the platform to speak about it. What you did wrong was how you conducted yourself after somebody pushed your button, right? That's what we're trying to speak about.
I get that. And I have gone through situations where groups like me, I was the one who spoke up. I was the one who shared my story. And as a result of that, there were men that would corner me and say, hey, thank you for sharing your story because this or this happened to me. Now, I'm not about just being a sexist or men's pain don't matter. Everybody pain matter. However, just because your pain matter does not give you the right to bark and scream and attack everybody. And I'm not afraid of God. That's not what I do because I don't usually conduct myself in a manner where I'm just attacking people. I don't do that. I don't.
Well, only thing that you can take from that experience is that he might have been dead wrong, but you know, there's going to be tons of people in the world that can be that way, but it's up to you on how you react and how that moves you. And anything can be a lesson. Everything can. And it doesn't have to be just because somebody did it. Matter of fact, it's a blessing that he didn't respond to you the way that you wanted to, because that's what the world is.
I know. So, I understand. I understand what you're saying.
Exactly what Kahan was saying. Take that and turn it into something. Turn it into the right kind of energy. That's the only thing you can do.
I understand what you're saying, and I'm taking all of to use it. And I really did not know that I was that sensitive about the situation. I didn't. I responded. What happened was it was an honest response. It was a very vulnerable response. Obviously, I did not mean to cause problems. Like you said, we can all learn from everything. But in
women this, but he is part of the problem. And if women is such a repulsiveness to you, then maybe you are looking for the wrong sex. You got to examine yourself with some of the stuff that, and I'm going to stand on what I said, because that's literally, that's the energy that you're putting out there. And I'm standing by what I said.
So she told him he's looking for the wrong sex, and she's standing on what she said.
Right, but I said
that's
that
an assault to any heterosexual male. If another man said that to another man, he would be ready to punch him in the grill.
They're fighting words.
They are fighting.
Basically, you're just trying to put the man into the alternative lifestyle.
That was very emasculated him right there in front of the panel and told him to go for his own sex.
I said maybe you're looking for love in the wrong sex because
no accountability again.
It was a jab. It was a jab. Just if it's a jab, just say it was.
I said that based on every time he gets on, like I said, my experience with him has always been him getting on and blah, 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 attacking, no kind of reason. He even was say what women don't. He said that something he said about women don't have resilience. Women don't have resilience. It's always saying.
Oh, I agree, sister. I agree. I totally agree with you. And you're right. I don't think that Clean is in a position mentally, emotionally, and I don't know about any other parts of that, but from his dialogue that he should be looking for a woman, because what he says and his negative outlook and perception of women is exactly what he's attracting. Women are this, women are that. And that's exactly the woman that he's going to get. Now, and this comes back to this. what's your role in learning how to deal with a person like that? Is there a way to learn something? I mean, we remember the cartoon, or not the commercial growing up. You can learn a lot from a dummy, you know? Just because somebody is running off at the mouth, maybe that's a test for your patience. Maybe that's a test of your grace, and maybe slowing down for a second and asking the Most High for the right words and the right spirit to speak with a person like that. Right. It's, I think that the opportunity for the lesson is way bigger than taking the victim stance, because it's really easy. Oh, you did this first to me. Well, the world's always going to be whooping on us. I mean, the fact that you even had something traumatic to talk about is testament to the fact that, you know, we get whooped through life, but we try to minimize those by making the right decisions, and also knowing who, you know, what battles and what conversations to have with who and at what times. You know, we got to just take it for face value, an opportunity to grow. Because is he right about, you know, what he said? You know what? Maybe he was about certain things, but we weren't ready to hear it. Maybe he was completely wrong. And it's your opportunity to say, hey, it's okay for somebody to think that, because you know, that's their paradigm. That's their point of view.